He's surely alive. He's living on the inside. Going like a lion. God's not there. He's surely alive. He's living on the inside. Going like a lion. God's not there. He's surely alive. He's living on the inside. Going like a lion. God's not there. He's surely alive. He's living on the inside. Going like a lion.
Somebody shout to the Lord.
No bounds. Your goodness never stops. Your mercy follows me. Your kindness fills my life. Your love amazes me. Yeah. And I sing because you are good. And I dance because you are good. And I shout because you are good. You are good to me. Because you are good, and I dance because you are good, and I shout because you are good, you are good.
Come on, somebody lift up a shout of praise. Yeah! Hallelujah! We praise you, Lord. Nothing and no one.
Nothing and no one comes anywhere close to you. The earth and oceans deep only reflect this truth. And in my darkest night, you shine as bright as day. Your love amazes me.
Go.
And I sing because you are good. And I dance because you are good. And I shout because you are good to me. And I sing because you are good. And I dance because you are good. And I shout because you are good. You are good.
Come on, with a cry of praise.
With a cry of praise, my heart will proclaim. You are good.
Because
you are good, and I dance because you are good, and I shout.
the Lord tonight. This is called Hallelujah Night. Can I hear a hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
Oh, come on, more than...
Hallelujah!
Hey, the world thinks they have a great party going on, but they don't know what it's all about, do they? We worship a living God, and tonight we got some excitement. You'll probably want to stay on your feet for a couple minutes, because these guys won a 500 bucks about a month ago, and they're called Well-Rounded. So try to catch the beat. Listen up. Go. Got it?
You know, what an incredible talent we have here tonight. Amen. I'm Pastor Margaret Rogers, and we want to welcome everyone to this exciting event. You know, this is one of the most wonderful things we do all year for our families. Families to enjoy a night of celebration together. And so on behalf of Pastor Bob and I, we want to welcome all of you. If this is your first time to be at a Hallelujah Night, raise your hand. Wow, look at all of our first time Hallelujah Night. We welcome you. And we are going to have an awesome time tonight. As you can see, this is not just Evangel World Prayer Center. This is the land of Oz tonight. And all of our kids are going to be excited to see this wonderful production. They're going to be meeting those characters very soon. And also, we have a great time outside. You're going to hear about that later. But we want to welcome you. So have a seat, and let's get ready for a wonderful time together here at Evangel World Prayer Center. And come and welcome right now,
oh, come on. Pastor Dave. Better than that. Let's go. Amen. How many of you know you can have a good time in the house of the Lord? All right. We're getting ready to start. And I do want to remind you as families, especially to our children, once the production begins, We're going to ask that you please keep the aisles clear, minimize moving around as much as possible. I know a number of you have the glow rings. We're going to need you during the production. I'll tell you when to help me, and you're going to be helping Dorothy. So we'll tell you more about that in just a few moments. But this is going to be a great night, and I want you to enjoy what happens here this evening. It's going to be a night where we're going to see something we're very familiar with, but help use it to help us understand a greater truth and a greater reality. So without further ado, it's my pleasure to introduce Dorothy's Yellow Brick Road.
Do you see that? Tick, tock, tick. 1 hour. That's how much longer you've got to be alive. And it isn't long, my pretty, it isn't long. I can't wait forever for those shoes. My feet are itching. I'll be back in exactly an hour to claim what is mine.
Welcome, friends. I was just getting my balloon tied down. See, there's a storm brewing, and that means one thing. We are in for some fun times. You know, this weather is just as bad as it was when Dorothy came. Did you know Dorothy? She was a great girl. In fact, did you know that she saved Oz? Sure did. In fact, I made 3 new friends the day she came to see me. Heck, she even helped me. Her and that story she told me about her. Hey, want me to tell you the story? Okay, let's see. Let's start, I guess, at the beginning. See, Dorothy lived with her aunt in Kansas, and one day an event so big, so gigantic, so amazing happened that it changed her life forever. She was caught in a storm. The winds were blowing, and she ran into her home instead of the cellar with the family, her and that little dog, Toto. Anyways, the storm got so big, it ripped the house right up. Oh, don't worry. Dorothy was okay. She stayed in the house as the wind blew all around her. So, okay, somehow she opened a portal from her world to ours, inside the storm. Now, I've never figured out how. Well, what happened next was just simple physics. What goes up must come down. And down she came, right on top of one of the most evil, mean, unnice people you would have ever met. And that's where Dorothy's problems really began.
Hornets!
Thank you. dear. Auntie M? Auntie M, can you hear me? Where are you?
Dorothy! Oh, Dorothy!
Who's there? Can you hear me? Who are you? Where are you? Where am I? This is all just too much. I don't want to be here.
Oh, but Dorothy, we'll be spending a lot of time together, you and me.
No, I don't think I want to do that. How about you, Toto? If it's all the same, I think we should find our way home.
Oh, Dorothy, this is your home. Your home.
No, see, I'm from Kansas, but I don't think I'm in Kansas anymore.
Defaming opera wizard with her calumnies and lies. She lies. Save us from the wicked. Share the song, we won't be led. Give us warning, where will she strike next? Where will she strike next?
They're trying to take us away.
This one's mine. Get her, demon.
Witch, Dorothy, I'm Pastor Kevin, and I've come to give you some help. You're going to be all right. Amen. Now listen, you're on a very important journey, and God has a great plan for your life. This road that you're walking on is a road that leads to redemption. And I want to share with you a couple things that's going to help you on your journey. First of all, see those beautiful red shoes? That red represents the blood of Jesus. And the blood of Jesus is powerful to defeat every form of evil, including the wicked witch of hell. So you don't ever have to be afraid. If she comes along your way, along with her imps again, you just look at those shoes and you start talking about the blood of Jesus, and you'll have power and authority even over that wicked witch. Now, not only that, but tonight we have some more help for you, because I brought you a special ring, and it lights up because it represents the light of the world, Jesus Christ. But not only that, I've recruited some helpers that are going to remind you of that tonight, and I'd like for all of you who are going to help Dorothy to lift your lights high. So whenever the Wicked Witch of the West shows up, I want all of you to lift your lights high, and that'll be an encouragement to help you, Dorothy. Do you think you can make it?
Thank you so much.
It's so important that you finish walking down this yellow brick road, because you're going to help others along the way, and you will be blessed. So you hang in there and don't you give up. You're going to win in the end.
Thank you so much. I will follow this yellow brick road.
Wonderful. God bless you.
Pain apart. my bed, the flaking plaster overhead. I miss it now. Someday I'll wake and rub my eyes, and in that land beyond the skies, you'll find me. And I'll be home.
Dorothy was really scared of that witch, but that man helped her overcome her fears, and her journey started. See, she was walking along when she came upon this very odd creature.
Boo!
It moved, Toto. It moved and spoke. Boo!
Yes, Boo.
Toto? This is strange. Mr. Scarecrow, why are you saying boo?
That's what scarecrows do. We scare things off.
Oh, yes, that makes sense. But, Mr. Scarecrow?
Yes? What is it?
You're not scary.
Yes, I know. That's why these birds keep eating all the crops.
Do you know how to be a good scarecrow?
Well, I guess not.
Oh, Mr. Scarecrow, don't cry. I'm sorry. He is very sensitive, Toto.
Sensitive? What? Who, me? I'm not sensitive. You're just rude.
Rude? I was just walking here, and you tried to scare me. But I'll tell you this, I'm not scared of you.
See? That's my problem. I wish I had a brain so I would know how to be a better scarecrow.
You don't have a brain.
Nope, just straw under this hat. I always wanted to be a doctor.
A doctor with no brain?
Well, no, you can't be a doctor without a brain. I said I wanted to be one, but without anything inside, I'm not good for anything.
Wait, Mr. Scarecrow, I know who can help you. A pastor I met a little bit ago. Pastor, can you help us?
Well, I believe that I can.
Wow, I feel better already.
Hello, Mr. Scarecrow. It's so nice to meet you. Now, did I hear you saying that you don't have a brain? Well, I want to help you with that, because the fact of the matter is, all of us have the mind of Christ. It tells us in Philippians chapter 2 and verse 5 that we're to take on the mind of Christ. And so when you have Jesus in your heart, you can know that you have a mind. It's a special kind of mind, even for you, Mr. Scarecrow. Not only that, but we know from Philippians that if we'll make our requests known to God, we'll have a peace that passes all understanding that'll keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Jesus came for you to have a purpose and to have direction in your life. And just like Dorothy's going down this yellow brick road, fulfilling her destiny in life, you too can fulfill your destiny. And to help you remember that, I want to present to you a diploma that you have graduated with the mind of Christ. Will you keep that with you at all times? All right. Now, here's what I need you to know. Anytime the Wicked Witch of the West tries to show up, because even after you know you have the mind of Christ or the blood of Jesus or Jesus is your light, the evil will still come to try to discourage you or try to make you think that you can't make it. But you will make it with the help of the Lord. So continue down on this path and fulfill your destiny. Will you do that? All right. God bless you. It's so good to meet you. You have a wonderful time. Dorothy, good to see you again.
You
God bless
too.
You.
Wow, I feel better already. 2 + 2 = 5. No, wait, it's some...
Oh, dear.
Wait, I got it. It's 2 + 2 = 4. 2 + 2 = 4. 2 + 2 = 4.
Wow, it did work.
This is amazing.
Scarecrow, calm down before you fall apart.
Dorothy! Oh, Dorothy! Did you think I was gone? If I can't stop you, how about I stop your new friend, Mr. Scarecrow? Oh, Mr. Scarecrow, tell me, how do you like fire?
Fire,
fire, fire.
Oh, Dorothy, help me. What can I do? That fire will be the end of me.
Here, Mr. Scarecrow, hold on to me. Blood of Jesus, save us.
No! No! Not again!
Not again!
Not, again.
Not the blood! Not the blood! Not the blood!
Scarecrow, let's go before she comes back.
On their journey with that evil devil witch nowhere to be found, when they came upon the oddest creature either of them had ever seen.
Scarecrow, do you see that?
Yeah, it looks like a tin man.
A tin man? What is that? Wait, I think he's talking.
Did he say he needs an oar? For what? There's no lake for miles.
No, I don't think he said ore. I think he said oil. He needs oil. Look for an oil can.
Got it. Now what?
Well, I guess we should put it on him, probably.
Wait, I'll ask him. Where should we put the oil?
Here, give me the oil. Let me put it around his mouth so he can talk.
Why are you yelling at me? I'm not deaf. I can't move. I'm rusted.
Sorry you're rusted. Hey, can I call you Rusty? You know, you shouldn't get wet. Tin rusts when it gets wet. Hey, Rusty, how about some...
Mr. Scarecrow, help me get him up.
And a one. And a two. And a three!
Oh, dear.
I'm okay. He broke my fall.
Get him off me!
They found out why the Tin Man was there. See, the evil witch cast a spell on him, making him a Tin Man. And then she took away his heart, so he couldn't love anymore. He told them how he used to help people all the time, build houses and cut down trees. But when that witch came and turned him into tin and took away his heart, he couldn't do it anymore. See, people started laughing. They said he looked funny, and they no longer wanted to be around him. So he went out to the forest, sat down, and started crying. The next thing he knew, well, you guessed it, Rust City.
That's terrible, Mr. Tin Man.
Yeah, Rusty, terrible.
I know who can help. Pastor. Oh, Pastor, where is he? Pastor?
Here I come, Dorothy. Here I come. Hi, Dorothy. How can I help?
Well, Tin Man doesn't have a heart.
Tin Man?
Yeah.
Who's... Oh, you must be Tin Man. It's so nice to meet you. And what is the problem?
He doesn't have a heart.
Doesn't have a heart? Oh, Tin Man, then I know just what you need. You need a relationship with Jesus, because he'll put within you a new heart. A new heart for you. Would you pray with me?
Yes.
All right, say this after me. Say, Dear Lord Jesus.
Dear Lord Jesus.
Forgive me of my sins.
Forgive me of my sins.
Come into my life.
Come into my life.
Give me a new heart.
Give me a new heart.
And I thank you for it now.
And I thank you for it now.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, when we pray and ask Jesus to come into our life, our hearts are made new. In fact, Jesus cares so much about your heart. He once said in John 14, "Don't let your heart be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me." Do you believe in Jesus?
Yes, sir. Now I do.
Well, I believe that. And because of that, I want to present you with this heart medallion that you can keep as a reminder of what Jesus has done in you. Now listen, even after we have a new heart, sometimes the wicked one, the wicked witch of hell, might come and try to discourage you or make you to believe it's not true. And that's where it's important that you say what we've said here tonight, that you do have a new heart and that your heart is alive in Christ. And just like Mr. Scarecrow has his brain and he's doing great, Dorothy's got the blood of Jesus as her reminder. And can we have all of our help by lifting the lights? That'll help you to know that you too can make this journey down the yellow brick road and fulfill your destiny. Okay?
Yes.
All right. God bless you. It's so nice to meet you. We'll see you, Dorothy.
Thank you. Listen, I'm trying to get back home. The witch brought me here, but I met a man who told me that if I follow this yellow road to the Emerald City, that there I can find my way home. Now I figure if the Emerald City will help me, then it can help you.
Oh no, Dorothy, it's that evil witch I was telling you about.
Oh, Tin Man, no one loves you anymore. They all think you're ugly. And if they don't love you, why should you ever love them? That's why you have no heart. You don't deserve, Hold him down and pour the water on him. We're going to rest him so much. He will never move again.
Dorothy, what are we going to do?
I know what I'm going to do. Run!
No, Scarecrow, you can't run away. We have to help Tin Man. Hold on to me. I plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus. Say it with me.
I plead the blood of Jesus.
No! Not again! Not again!
Not again!
Satan, the blood of Jesus is against you. Satan, the blood of Jesus is against you.
Yeah, Russ, get the lead out. Let's go.
Witch had no power over Dorothy and her friends when she used the blood of Jesus. But there was still one more friend to meet, and this one was a beast. Well, kind of.
Protect you, Dorothy.
Don't hurt me. I'm sorry.
Sorry? What kind of lion are you?
I'm not a very good one. I have no courage.
No courage?
That's no excuse to scare people.
I'm sorry. I'm not a very good lion. I was surrounding my family.
Well, I see you filled out nicely.
Stop it, Scarecrow. Why don't you have any courage, Mr. Lion?
That lion told Dorothy a terrible tale of how the witch took away his courage, and ever since he has hidden far away in the woods of rebuke. But things were just about ready to go from bad to downright evil. See, Dorothy was running out of time to get to Oz, and that evil, despicable, downright ugly witch was on their tail.
Mr. Lion, we're on our way to the Emerald City, and I think you should go with us. But first, I know who can help you. Pastor, where are you? Please come and help Mr. Lion.
Here I am, Dorothy. Who is your new friend? Well, whoa, Mr. Lion.
Don't worry, he's not scary.
Oh, well, Mr. Lion, it's a pleasure to meet you. Come right over here and let's have a talk. What seems to be the problem?
I have no courage.
No courage? But you're the king of the jungle.
I'm supposed to be, but the Wicked Witch of the West, she stole my courage from me.
This is a terrible problem, but I've got good news. Even though it's a common problem that I come across, where people have been told lies by the devil, made to think that they couldn't be strong and courageous, the truth is, when you meet Jesus and he lives in you, you can have all the courage that you need. Would you like to receive Jesus tonight?
Yes, sir.
Why don't you pray this after me? Say, Dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus.
Forgive me of my sins.
Forgive me of my sins.
And come into my heart.
And come into my heart.
I need your courage.
I need your courage.
I need your strength.
I need your strength.
And I receive it tonight.
And I receive it tonight.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
You see there, you already got mighty name. All right. Now, I want to give you a couple of scriptures because it's good to stand on the word.
Yes, sir.
1 John 4:4 says, greater is he that is in me than he that's in the world. Who's in you, Lion?
Jesus.
Jesus says,
Not only that, 2 Timothy 1:7 says he has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and love and a sound mind. Amen. So you just go forth proclaiming the word, and you have all the courage that you need. You are mighty in God. Amen?
Amen.
No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Now, here's something else to remember. Even when your courage is restored, you're going to be tested. That wicked witch from hell is going to try to test you, and the wicked ones will do the same. But remember, we've got Dorothy's shoes to remind us about the blood of Jesus. And the blood is more powerful than anything on earth. And you've got some great friends here who have a heart and have their brain. Now you have your courage. And we've got all these friends here tonight that are reminding us that Jesus is the light. And you're going to make it. And as you continue down the yellow brick road, you're going to fulfill God's destiny for all your lives. So I'm believing with you tonight. Now, before you go on your journey, I've got something for you. I want to present to you, Mr. Lion, the medallion of courage to always remind you that you do have courage and you are brave. All right?
All right.
All right. Well, God bless you. It's been great to meet you and to see everybody again. And I'm believing for the great results of your journey being completed. Thank you, Dorothy.
Thank you, Pastor.
All right. God bless you.
Wow, Mr. Lion, see? Now you can go with us to Oz and you won't be afraid.
I have had just about all of you I want to deal with, Dorothy. Surround them. Let's end this once and for all.
What are we going to do, Dorothy?
We have to stay and fight.
You fight. I'm going to play dead.
Take those slippers off her feet and bring them to me, to me, to me.
We have to rebuke the enemy with the blood of Jesus. Come on, get up and say it with me. We rebuke you with the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus over us.
No, not this time. They are mine.
I plead the blood of Jesus over us.
It's working, Dorothy. Pleading the blood of Jesus is working.
Come on, Scarecrow. Louder. Growl it. Rah!
I plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus.
No! Not again! Not again!
The blood of Jesus is against you.
Something has changed within me. Something is not the same. I'm through with playing by the rules of someone else's game. Too late for second guessing. Too late to go back to sleep. It's time to trust my Savior. Close my eyes and leave. It's time to try defying gravity. I think I'll try defying gravity, and you can pull me down.
I knew Dorothy had the whole thing under control. You know, It was right after that that Dorothy finally made her way to Oz with her friends. When I met them, they didn't really need my help. They never did. See, the power of the blood of Jesus saved them from that evil witch, not me. They had found the true power. Me, I'm just a hack behind a curtain. Jesus, now, there's the one who gets the praise, all of us.
I soar by defying gravity. Tell me goodbye, I'm defying gravity. And they can't pull me down. Together we're unlimited. Together we'll be the greatest team there's ever been. Dreams the way we planned them. If we work together, there's no fight we cannot win. Together.
Kansas. Oh, Toto, we're finally going home. My friends, I hate to leave so fast, but I must get home. Oh, Mr. Oz, will this balloon take me home?
Oh, yes, Dorothy, but hang on. It's going to be one amazing ride.
Too long, I've been afraid of losing love. I guess I never lost.
Some things I cannot change, but till I try, I'll never know.
I'm through accepting limits, because someone says they're so.
So if you care to find me, look to the southern sky. As someone told me lately, everyone deserves to try. And if I'm flying home, at last I'm flying free. To that witch who tried to ground me, take this message back from me. There is or ever was is ever gonna bring me down. Bring me down.
So she'll never bring us
down. Dorothy, we'll miss you. Bye.
Come on, let's give him a good hand. Didn't they do a great job? I'm going to ask the characters to come stand right here behind me, and Dorothy and Toto are going to make their way over. Tonight we've seen a wonderful presentation that helps us know that Jesus has a plan for our life. And he has steps that he's ordered just for you, whether you're 3 years old, 10 years old, anything in between or above. God wants to be the one that will guide you. And he has all the tools that you need to make it in life. And I'd like to take a moment, and we'll dismiss here in just a few minutes, but I'd like for us to take a moment and have a word of prayer. And maybe you're here tonight and you have never asked Jesus to come into your heart. We want to be able to pray with you and give you an opportunity, just like these characters did in the drama, to turn your heart over to Jesus so that you can fulfill the destiny that God has for your life. I'd like for everyone to bow your heads and close your eyes just for a moment.
I remember when I was 6 years old, I was seated in a church. It wasn't quite as big as this one. But I remembered, I felt Jesus tugging at my heart. And I felt like I needed to invite him into my life. So I tapped my mom on the shoulder and told her what was going on. And we went down to the altar and there we prayed. And if you're here tonight, whether young or old, and you would like to ask Jesus to come into your heart and be the Lord of your life, to help you on life's journey, I'd like for you to raise your hand real high. I see many hands going up all over. Well, here's what I'd like to do. I'd like to pray with all the children that are here. And mom and dad, if you want to come with them, I'd like for all the children to come and just fill in, come right up to the edge of the steps and fill in all across the front and around the front of this platform. And we're going to have prayer together before we continue on and enjoy the rest of this night. But these are the most important moments that we'll share right now. It's so wonderful to see so many of you coming, and we're going to pray together in just a moment. We want to give everyone an opportunity to come here to the front. Just fill in all across the front here. Yeah, give them a good hand. I'm going to ask you just to step back just slightly from the edge of this platform just to make sure we're safe. But if you're here and you want to ask Jesus to come into your heart, and others are still making their way, so you might have to fill in across the sides, even in the middle aisle here or in that aisle, I want you to place your hand over your heart right now. And you know, you may be in the congregation somewhere and say, I caught the message. And I need a change in my life. I need it to happen now. I want you to place your hand on your heart as well. And I want everyone to pray this with those that lifted their hand earlier and wanted to invite Jesus into their life. Some of you may have already done that, but this will help them as you pray with them, okay? Let's do this together. Say, Dear Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for me. You went into the grave and you rose from the dead and you're alive today. I ask you to forgive me of my sins and come into my heart. Be the Lord of my life. Help me to live for you all the days of my life. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, if you prayed that simple prayer, and you meant it in your heart, you were sincere, then that name means your name has been written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And we want to encourage you to follow Jesus and live for Him all of your life. Moms and dads, if you prayed that prayer, the same is true for you. It's never too late to start on the journey that God has in store for you. There's never too much life that's passed that you can't get into God's perfect plan for your life. Jeremiah 29:11 says, I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord. Thoughts of good and not of evil to give to you a future and a hope. God loves you and He's got a great plan for your life. And we here at Evangel, maybe you've come to visit from somewhere else, another good church. Churches like ours want to help you live for the Lord. So we encourage you to get plugged in and be a part of a fellowship somewhere where you can learn the things of the Bible, where you can worship the Lord together. If any of you would like to make contact with someone here at Evangel, we've got some pastors that are available, some men and women that'll be more than happy to take that information and gather it. If you'll just linger up here for a few moments, they'll be happy to go ahead and spread out in the crowd here. They can be seen. And they'll be glad to talk with you and pray with you and get your name and information. Before we go, I think we ought to one more time say thank you to these wonderful characters, all the musicians. The choir, let's give them a hand. I'd also like to thank some of the behind the scenes people. There's a lot of folks that you didn't see that were a part of this. We'd like to especially thank Trey Voltz for writing this and producing it.
Yeah.
Give him a great hand. Nick and Brittany and Rachel, and I'll probably forget someone, but they all did such a wonderful job.
Word Alive is a production of Bob Rogers Ministries in Louisville, Kentucky. For more information on the outreach of this ministry or to become a partner, visit bobrogersministries.org. And remember to like us on Facebook and Ustream, just search TV Word Alive.